Welcome to a new Daily Topaz Credit video. Today's topic: the closest orange object is the cause of your death. How do you die? As a ginger, I am strangled to death by my own hair. What a way to go. My ginger cat is on my lap. I think his plan is to annoy me to death. Your cat doesn't stand on you in your sleep. If my cats were orange, they'd definite crush my windpipe with their piercing paws of death. I ironically killed by a packet of Emergency. I have disinfecting wipes next to me. Too much healthy. Haha, I have ibuprofen. I'm going to get murdered by the one girl in my math class that has a bad spray tan. Imagine being one of Trump's advisors browsing Reddit and coming across this question during a meeting. Death by president. Does that mean Trump would have to kill himself? Fuck. Goodbye. r/IsisAvuja. I guess I choke to death on an earplug. Oh, or maybe some bacteria that goes through your ear canal and into your brain. Oh. What the fuck, I'm trying to sleep. I'm literally standing next to an orange shipping container FML. Flattened, nice. Now I'm paranoid because of my color blindness. Edit, was it really that funny? Get a dog to guard you. Oh wait, shit. He looked around from left to right. He cast his eyes below. He glanced ahead and turned his sight. Above, and to, and fro. He peered and scanned and spied and stared. He stopped, he paused a bit. He watched and viewed and gazed and glared. He softly whispered. Shit. Gatorade. Not much of it left, so I'm guessing I'll choke on it. Which is strange because it's not even my Gatorade, not sure why I'd be drinking my classmate's Gatorade. Or he's passing a superbug that's still in the incubation stage over to me. We die together, my bro, death by Gatorade. At least we'll go out refreshed. My human-sized cardboard Garfield wants lasagna, and apparently I didn't deliver. r/imsorijo. I always knew he would get me. Edit, forgot this k. That sick little smirk. That smile, that damn smile. A paper folder. Death by 1,000 paper cuts. There are few things worse than a paper cut. But 1,000. That's worse than Sitter himself. Imagine getting circumcised via a single long paper cut. Death by Tic Tac. What an awful way to go. Even worse. It's an orange Tic Tac which serves no purpose. Doesn't freshen your breath but leaves an orange stain on your tongue. Boyfla sticks out tongue trying to set off its orange. Blasphemy. It is clearly the best flavor. This is crazy to me. In Australia the orange Tic Tac is still white, just the box is orange. Orange is delicious. A sudden allergy from the blouse I am wearing right now. The orange t-shirt which I am wearing. It is going to squeeze me till eyes pop out. Then, the shit piss start coming out from every hole in the body and body pops from where blood splatters all around making whole room red. Dude, stop stealing my deathcore lyrics. My little toy alpaca becomes alive and throws its decorative pom-poms at me, which are surprisingly deadly. I wanna see an orange alpaca. Alpaca. I am sorry to let you down, just the pom-poms are orange, not the alpaca itself. Edit, thanks for all the awards, these are my first awards ever, my alpaca and I are very happy. P.S. I kinda realize now, it's more of a llama than an alpaca, oh well. Stabbed by a pencil. A fucking pencil. Three men in a bar. My maths notebook for school. I'll be mathed to death. Edit, geez, these math puns just keep multiplying. You'll be divided by zero. Heck, even divided by two would do it. It's going to be painful regardless, it's Lego. It's going to be painful regardless, it's Lego. Imagine suffocating in a giant tub of Lego, scratching yourself trying to get out. That's quite a gruesome image. My cat. I knew they hated me. It's always the ginger ones with a murderous glint in their eye, isn't it? They act all friendly. A bag of Cheetos. I guess I could choke on them, that's one way to go, I guess. I was munching on some Cheetos the exact moment I found this thread. I was an intense few moments considering whether or not to keep eating them. That little Reddit logo HMM. I'm guessing someone smashes my head in with my computer screen. I always thought it was red. You know, 'cause it's Reddit. I always thought Reddit was a play on Reddit. Ah. But there was a lengthy debate about what color the upvote button is. It's red-orange. That's orangered, not orange. You're safe. The Payub logo, I have a wood cut out of it. Congrats, you all masturbate death. He died as he lived. An old Earth gun. It's Earth or nothing. A plastic crab toy. It comes to life. I try to crush it, I can't, it is still plastic. It is too fast. Before I know what's happened, it skittered its way up my leg and quickly scales upward. It plunges a now deadly plastic claw into my neck. I bleed out, while still sitting on the toilet. Mine is a small plastic star-shaped bath toy. I guess it gets lodged in my throat. Ah, it comes to life too. Over the course of several hours, it slowly inches its way to your bedroom, watching, waiting. Finally, it has nestled itself directly behind your headboard where it plots your final moments. Slightly after 2 a.m. it will suction itself to your mouth and nose and you will die of asphyxiation. Reese's overdose. Not a bad way to go. His Majesty, just a pen. Alright, who wants to see a magic trick? For my next trick, I'm going to fucking kill myself. Yeah, it's a great trick, but I can only do it once. A literal orange fruit. Guess I choke. Mine is an orange too, my mind went with bag of oranges falling on my head. Not choking, cartoon bag of oranges. I genuinely looked around my room and didn't find anything orange. I'm immortal, bitches. Just means the thing that's going to kill you hasn't entered the room yet. Do you lack object permanence? Op is 6 months old, bruh. Dookie doubts straw. Revenge of the Sea Turtles. Same. The orange upvote arrow is actually physical and travels at high velocities when provoked. The SCP Foundation wants to know your location. Overdose on pill, bottle. Same here. The only thing orange within 20 feet of me is a prescription bottle. Hydrocodone. Well, you wouldn't be the first. Hit by a flying Nike shoe box. My parrot is constantly trying to kill me lately. This time she succeeds in her quest to rediscover her dinosaur roots and eats me alive while yelling, "Was it yummy? Was it really good?" Ironically, it's the filter of cigarettes in my ashtray. So I will die of smoking, but that's nothing new. I looked around and saw my orange American Spirit pack and was like, yeah, probably. A ticket validator in the tram. This will be a slow and excruciating death. I must try to eat this toxic highlighter at my desk. I just finished mine. I recommend lots of salt. Nasty vitamin C overdose. Home Depot bucket. I'm pretty sure I tripped and fell on it, $1 million baby style. Death by safety glasses is how I go, I guess. Ironic. Ironic. I get smothered by my blanket. A 6-tall inflatable turkey. I can't say I'm surprised. A calculator. I'll probably kill myself with it after it doesn't work on the final. Death by Ezits. I have long suspected this might happen. Well, fuck, I can't see any orange objects around me right now, so whatever it is going to be quite the surprise death. The sun. Ah, mate, it's yellow. Go on, have a stare, I'll wait. Donald Trump is on the TV, oh. My beard will kill me. Fair enough, it has been carrying the two of us so far in life. The walls of my house are orange, so I guess the house collapses and kills me. I never leave my house and now I die in it. What a way to go. The reflective vest is so good the driver can't see and plows right into me. Cause of death, an orange stickered cube from a miniature Rubik's cube. How it happened, a maintenance worker will be working in the ceiling just outside of my cubicle row, his ladder pressed against the wall of my cube. While on the ladder, and halfway through the ceiling panel inspecting an air duct, his loosely secured hammer will catch on the ceiling and fall out of his utility belt. The head of the hammer will land promptly on top of the miniature Rubik's cube, the weight applying pressure to it in a way it was not designed for. Within less than a mile Isgard, the cubes will fire in every separate direction that physics and their surroundings will permit. The cube that causes my death will fly into my open right eye as I turn to see what is happening. With the velocity at which it is traveling, sharp corner forward, it will by some marvel, manage to pierce its way almost all the way to the ocular nerve. At that moment I will jump up, and recoiling in pain I will trip over an untied shoelace, cracking my head against the corner of my desk and knocking myself out. The maintenance worker doesn't notice me passed out unconscious sticking halfway out from under the desk, and is wearing noise-cancelling earphones blasting Patera, so he has no clue what happened. Because I am alone in the office today after he leaves, nobody will find me until the custodians make their rounds doing the Friday vacumic and emptying trash cans. At this point, I am still unconscious. I do not wake up from the head injury for another day actually. When I come to, I am in the hospital. The doctor standing over me lets me know that they still need to monitor me, and they have done what they can for my eye. A large bandage covers it now. I look to my left and through my remaining eye, I see my fierce getting up from her seat, eyes welled up with tears, and rushing towards me. Fast forward about 2 months, and I have been released from the hospital for some time. It is about 7 p.m. on a Friday, just after the sun has set. I get in my car to make a last-minute trip to the store after having run home to feed our cats, since my fierce is working a later shift. At the second intersection I come across a red light. Once it turns green, I gun it, excited to finally be able to enjoy the feeling of my turbocharged car once again. Just past the middle of the intersection, while I am distracted by my A-pillar-mounted boost and AFR gauges giving unusual readings, possible boost leak. I get A-highlighted by a runaway semi-truck doing about 90 miles per hour that hit me from my right. Apparently the driver had a heart attack at the wheel, lost consciousness, and his foot somehow became wedged against the gas pedal. My lack of peripheral vision in my right eye, caused by the little orange square on the miniature Rubik's cube, coupled with a distraction ultimately led to my death. Boy, it was a stretch figuring out how this one would work.